Hello everyone, welcome to yourfaculty.com, a premier test preparation portal for GRE, CAT and BAC exams. Today we are going to deal with this topic, interest. I hope you got chance to go through our previous videos on percentages. Lot of the concepts that I explained there and are used here. So let me move on to the topic. In the meantime, do visit our website www.yourfaculty.com and do like us in our Facebook page, Your Faculty. So moving on, what are the different components in an interest? So let me try to explain the different aspects. Simple interest is one important thing. It is basically calculated on the basis of an amount borrowed over a period of time at a rate of interest. So what does this mean? It means that if there is a particular principal that you borrow from a bank, a particular amount. Right, and that's called as principal, and the bank charges you back a rate of interest. Right, so they would say that you have to pay, let's say 5% per annum. That's a key word here. And you say that you will pay back over a period of, over a period of 5 years or n years. And that's called number of years. So all this comes into your calculation for simple interest. So what happens here is your simple interest is basically calculated as P into N into R by 100. And this 100 is basically your R percentage that you see over here. So what are you trying to achieve here? We are basically trying to achieve a particular percentage value of principal that you have to pay in that n number of years. For example, all that it means is from your, let's take what you understood from your percentage calculation. You are supposed to pay 5% of a sum P, and since this 5% is paid over a period of n years, you are basically paying n into r percentage of the principal P, your percentage concept. That is what is being applied over here. The only difference is that the principal remains same for all the 5 years. You are not adding the interest gained in the first year to the principal of the second year. So here the principal is flat for 5 years and the interest is calculated as P into N into R by 100, or in short PNR by 100. I'm sure it is easy for you to remember. You need to catch this word simple interest, or else the question will specifically have this mention of compounded annually. Now, what do we find here? We find the interest. And is this the final answer? No. We are supposed to find out the amount that we get at the end of 5 years or n years. And how do we get that? So the amount A is equal to P plus I. So principal is the amount that you have, the actual amount that you have borrowed, and interest is the amount charged by the bank, and when you sum this up both, you will know at the end of 5 years how much you are paying. Now, banks won't be charging you at this rate. What do banks do? Banks actually do it at compound interest. If they do it at simple interest, it would all be great for us. Now, they do it at compound interest. What do you mean by compound interest? Compound interest is the interest of previous year is added as principal for the calculation. So you do simple interest calculation for every year and revise the principal for the next year. How do you do that? Let's take an example here. Let's say the principal is $100 and rate of interest is 10% and n is equal to 3 years. Now what happens in a compound interest calculation? In a compound interest calculation, you are supposed to do it for every year. Let's take for example first year. At the end of first year, what do you get if you do PNR by 100? You get 100 into 10. Here, n is equal to 1 because we are doing it for every year. 1 by 100. And what do you get? You get 10. You get $10 as interest. And now, the new principal for the next year is basically the principal for the previous year was 100 and the interest from the previous year was 10, which is basically 110. So what happens now? The new calculation that you are supposed to do, you will do it 110 into 10 into 1 by 100 and you get the answer as 11. And now what is your new principal? Your new principal is P1, which is 110 plus we'll call it I2, the interest that you got from the second year. And your new value is 121. Similarly, now if you have to do for the third year, this is for the second year. Third year, you'll do it at 121 into 10 into 1 by 100, which is equal to, you cancel everything, you get $12.1. And you sum it up, your final amount comes to 121 plus 12.1. So this is the calculation that you are doing to get the amount at the end of 3 years. So we apply the same percentage concept. We know that the percentage, 10% is going to remain same and the years are going to be 3 years. So what do we do? The concept is pretty simple. P into 1.1, if you remember the calculation that we had done, 1.1 into 1.1, so which is equal to P into 1.1 to the power of 3, right? To make it even more simple, there is a formula for compound interest. And how do we do that? Amount is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 power n, which is precisely what we have derived here. In this case, in this particular example, it was 10 by 100, which is basically equal to 0.1. So it became 1.1 to the power of 3. So if you understand percentage very well, remembering this formula is also very easy. And all that we are doing is A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 power n. I'm sure you don't have to waste your time in your exam to understand this formula. You can as well remember this formula to if the question says compounded annually. What I have tried to do here is to explain the basis for this formula. And the base for all these formulas is your percentage. Now let's try to solve some problems. I'm sure you're all eagerly waiting to understand some of the problems. I will try to take up the first question over here. The simple interest. The question clearly says the simple interest on a money is 25% of the principal and the rate per annum is equal to the number of years. Now these are the kind of questions that keep coming up in bank exams or CAT or any other competitive exams like GRE or anything. Now how do we start this? We know that the principal is P, we'll maintain it. Then what else is given? The simple interest on a money is 25% of the principal. And what is the simple interest? It's basically P by 4. And they have also told that the rate per annum is equal to number of years. So R is equal to N because these and these are equal. Now, how do we? What is the formula that we have? I is equal to PNR by 100. And what is I here? I is equal to P by 4 and P into N into R is equal to N, so we put N by 100. We cancel P and P and we get N square is equal to 100 by 4 which is basically equal to 25, and therefore n square is equal to 25, so n is equal to 5. So we know that r and n are same, so we can say that the rate of interest is equal to 5%. Okay, moving on to the next question. A sum of money triples itself in 10 years. Find the rate of interest per annum. So this is key here, the money triples itself. So what do you mean by money tripling? Let's say we are given the value P. So for the value to become 3 times, or let's say 2 times, so how do you represent it? You represent it as 2P. So what does this mean? If you understand this, the problem is basically very simple. It means that there is some other value called P that got it added to it to make it twice. Now, a value is given and the value became 3 times, 3P. So for this to become 3P, what are we doing? We are actually adding something called 2P to make it 3 times. The money triples. The money was P and became 3P. So to make it 3P, we make P plus 2P is equal to 3P. If you understand this clearly, what is this particular component actually? The P or 2P which I have placed over here. The P or 3P that I, the 2P that I have placed over here, if you try to understand what it is basically the additional amount that you're getting as interest or whatever by investment or through bank or whatever. So this I is basically the new P. It's the interest component that is helping you double or triple. So from this, what do we understand? As per the question, I is actually equal to 2P. And they are given N as 10. And what are they asked to us to find out? They ask us to find out R. So how do we do it? We know that I is equal to PNR by 100. And I is equal to 2P. And P into N is equal to 10 into R by 100. We can cancel these. We can cancel this. And we get R is equal to 20%. Isn't it easy? So the key here is, before you apply this formula, the key is to find out the value of I, and the value of I can be arrived by applying this concept. Thanks for watching the video. You can also subscribe to Your Faculty channel in YouTube and also like us in Facebook and LinkedIn. Thank you.